Hello everyone, in this video lecture or today's lecture we'll discuss the concept of the shielding effect, which is also known as the screening effect. So another name of the shielding effect is the screening effect. So let's start or let's discuss what is the meaning of this shielding effect, how the shielding effect works, and what are the applications of this shielding effect or the screening effects. So now look at this, we have a diagram. Let me explain by use of the diagram first, then we'll take up later on. So now look at this, at the center of this atom we have this positively charged nucleus. This is nucleus which is positively charged, which is placed exactly at the center of the atom. Around this nucleus we have orbits in which electrons are moving. So we have this positively charged nucleus which is placed at the exactly at the center of atom. Around this we have electrons moving in circular orbits. Inside these orbits we have sub shells, then we have orbitals. So we are just talking about this circular orbit. Now let's take this to be the valency shell. Valency shell means the outermost shell in which electron is being present. So the highest occupied shell is known as the valency shell, or the outermost shell or the orbit in which the electron is being present, that is known as the valency shell. Now since the highest occupied shell is this valency shell, inside this we have a number of shells, and all these shells do contain certain electrons, and we know the electrons are negatively charged, as we have discussed during this cathode ray experiment or as discussed by J.J. Thomson. So now we have this. So if you look at this, this electron which is present at the valency shell, jo sabse outermost shell mein jo electron hai. Now this electron is negatively charged, nucleus is positively charged, so this electron present in the valency shell will be attracted by the positive charge which is present inside the nucleus. That means this electron, the negatively charged electron, the present in the valency shell will be attracted by the total number of the protons present in the nucleus, that is the atomic number or the Z. But what we are seeing here is this electron is simultaneously attracted by the positive charge of the nucleus, so this represents the attractive force. Now in between this valence electron and the nucleus we have a number of intervening shells. These intervening shells do contain electrons, and we know electrons are negatively charged, so same charges undergoes repulsive force. So the electrons present in the valency shell is being repelled by electrons present in the intervening shell. So this electron will repel this electron will also undergo repulsive force, this electron will also exercise the repulsive force on the electron present in the valency shell. So this electron which is present in the valency shell undergoes two types of force, means this is experiencing two types of force. One, that is the attractive force due to the new positive charge of the nucleus. Simultaneously this electron is also experiencing the repulsive force due to the intervening shells. So the combined effect of this attractive force by the nucleus and the repulsive force by this electron, the valency shell electron is experiencing less attractive force by the nucleus. So the actual attractive force felt by this valency shell electrons due to the repulsive force of this intervening electron, that is known as the effective nuclear charge. So this electron which was supposed to be attracted by this atomic number Z will experience less attractive force due to the presence of this intervening electrons. Because of this, these electrons will always experience less attractive force. That is the meaning of the effective nuclear charge. So we have looked at this a term that is known as the effective nuclear charge. Effective nuclear charge. This effective nuclear charge, this is defined as Z effective or simply as Z star. So this is effective nuclear charge. This effective nuclear charge is equals to Z, that is the actual nuclear charge that is present in the nucleus, minus some constant which is known as the shielding constant or the screening constant. This is the effective pull experienced by this electron due to the repulsive force of these intervening electrons. This is equals to the theoretical value, that is Z, the theoretical value minus some constant. That constant is what we call as the shielding constant or the shielding effect. That means this intervening electron shield this outer electron from the attractive force of the nucleus, means ek diwar ki tarah ban gaya, ek layer. Because of this layer, the interaction between this valence electron and the nucleus is decreased. So that is what we call as the shielding effect. So what is Z? That is atomic number, and this sigma, this is known as shielding constant. Shielding constant or known as screening constant, because this screens the outer electron from the attractive force of the nucleus. So we have this Z effective, that is effectively how much attractive force is felt by this valence electron due to the repulsive force of the inner shell electrons. So this is defined as the actual attractive force felt by the outer shell electrons due to the repulsive force of intervening inner shell electrons. So this actual attractive force is always less than the theoretical attractive force which was supposed to be felt by the outer electrons. So because of this repulsive force, the attractive force felt by the outer shell electron is decreased, which we define as this effective nuclear charge. Now, how to find out the effective nuclear charge? Then we have this term, because we have to define this shielding effect. Now look at this shielding effect, which is given another name as screening constant. That means these inner shell electrons shields or screens the outer shell electron from the attractive force of the nucleus. That is what we call as the shielding or screening. As I told you, this represents the repulsive force due to same charge. This represents the attractive force due to opposite charge. Now this shielding effect depends on the orbital in which the electron is being placed. Now in a given shell, we have number of subshells. In a shell, that means in a given value of the principal quantum number, we have a number of subshells. Inside these subshells, we have different types of orbitals. Now, in a shell means the value of n, that is principal quantum number, being constant. We have different types of subshell S, P, D, F, etc. Now, these subshells present in a given shell has got some penetrating power. Penetrating power means the extent up to which the shell is closer to the nucleus. ये न्यूक्लियस के पास सबसे ज्यादा कौन पेनेट्रेट कर सकता है, दैट इज व्हाट वी कॉल इज द पेनेट्रेशन पावर. सो व्हेन वी टेक द पेनेट्रेशन पावर ऑफ ए सबशेल इज ग्रेटर देन पी, देन व्हिच इज ग्रेटर देन व्हिच इज डी व्हिच इज ग्रेटर देन एफ, एफ इज ग्रेटर देन जी एटसेट्रा. सो दिस रिप्रेजेंट्स द पेनेट्रेशन इफेक्ट. दैट मीन्स how close the subshells are towards the nucleus, in nucleus ke sabse kareeb kitna ja sakte hain. The closeness of these subshells towards the nucleus, that is what equal as the penetration effect. So in a given shell, the A subshell is closest to the nucleus, followed by P, followed by D, followed by F, that is closeness. Closeness to the nucleus. Now, A subshell being closest to the nucleus, the electrons present in A subshell will be much strongly attracted by the nucleus, whereas the P subshell being a slightly greater distance from the nucleus, and in between this P, we also have A subshell. So, electrons placed in P subshell will have less attractive attraction from the nucleus. So, as the distance from the nucleus of these subshells increases, the attractive force felt by the electrons in that subshell keeps on decreasing. So, that means the S electron being closest to the nucleus will be strongly attracted by the nucleus, whereas P attractive force will be less, means these electrons present in P will feel some repulsive force from the electrons present in the S subshell. So, based on this penetration effect, we can say the S orbital or the S subshell has got more shielding effect than electrons present in the P. So, therefore, the shielding effect. Shielding effect also shows the same. S orbital electrons has got stronger shielding effect than P. P is greater than D, D is greater than F. So we simply say electrons present in D and F are having very poor shielding effect. The shield, this is due to the diffuse structure of the D and F. As we have seen the structure of shape of this orbital, D has got double dumbbell, F, so this is much complicated, which we cannot visualize with a naked eyes. So now look at this, due to the diffused shape of this D and F, the shielding effect or the shielding capacity of the electrons present in D and F are very poor. So the shielding effect being very poor, the shielding constant will be less. As the shielding constant is less, the effective nuclear charge felt by the electrons will be more. So now look at this. This is the shielding effect. The shielding effect is this sigma. So the sigma values depends on this penetration effect. The electrons present in S will have much stronger value of shielding effect. That means the value of sigma, that is a shielding constant or the screening constant, will be more. As the screening constant is more, this difference will be less. So the effective nuclear charge felt by the electrons will be less. So now simply saying now, when we have this distribution of electrons in various shells, so the outer shell electrons will always felt less effective force of the nucleus. This is due to the repulsive force experienced by these outer shell electrons due to the inner shell electrons. This is what we call as shielding effect. Now, this constant, as I told you, depends on the electrons in which sorry, orbitals or the subshells in which electron is present, and this also depends on the penetration effect, that is closeness to the nucleus. S orbital being closest will have stronger shielding effect than P, then D, F. D and F, due to the diffuse structure, the shielding effect is very poor. If the shielding effect is very poor, the sigma value will be less. So J minus sigma will be having larger value, and we can say this effective nuclear charge will be more, or the attractive force felt by the electrons will be more. So this is what we call as the effective nuclear charge or the shielding effect. Now to calculate this shielding effect, we have to define some electronic configuration that is based on the Slater's rule. Calculate this shielding constant or the screening constant, we have a rule which is known as Slater rule. Now for this Slater rule, we have grouped the different orbitals in this way, that is electronic configuration. So we have look at this 1s, then we have 2s, 2p, then we have 3s, 3p, 3d, then we have 4s, 4p. Yes, sir, this is how we group the different orbitals for writing electronic configuration. Even if you don't know this grouping, then we can also derive this value of sigma. So now this contribution of the electrons present in this orbitals, for this s and p orbital electrons present in n, that is n minus 1, n minus 2, n minus 3, n minus 4, if n is the valence shell. So for every electron present in valence shell, that is the outermost shell, there is a contribution of 0.35 towards the shielding. That means every electron present in the valence shell, that outermost shell shell will have a contribution of 0.35 towards the shielding effect. For electrons present in n minus 1, so n is the valence shell, this is valence shell, outermost shell, n minus 1, that is just next to the valence shell, just in next to the valence shell, that is known as penultimate shell. So electrons, every electrons present in penultimate shell will have a contribution of 0.85 towards the shielding effect. And for electrons present in n minus 2, n minus 3 and n minus 4 etc., each will have a contribution of 1 towards the shielding effect. Whereas for electrons present in d orbital, the valence shell will have a contribution of 0.35, and electrons present in n minus 1 will have a contribution of 1, n minus 2, n minus 3, n minus 4 also will have a contribution of this 1 towards the shielding effect. So we have to remember this, the contribution of electrons in various orbitals towards the shielding. So once we know this contribution, we can easily define what is the values of sigma. Once we know the values of sigma, we can easily define the effective nuclear charge. So let's start with this. Let's give you some examples. Let's take this hydrogen. We have one electron. Electronic configuration is 1s1. Now look at this. In this hydrogen containing one electron. Now look at this, we have only one electron, so there is no other electron. So the shielding effect of this one electron will always be zero, because we have to find the effect of shielding on this one electron. So there is no other electron, so there is no repulsive force, no attractive force, only the force felt by this electron is the attractive force of the nucleus. So the shielding effect of this electron will be zero. If the shielding effect is zero, then J effective of this electron of hydrogen is always equals to the theoretical values of the nuclear charge, that is atomic number. Now let's take this case helium atomic number 2. We have this electronic configuration 1s2. So if you look at this, both the electrons are present in the first shell. So now out of these two electrons, we have to consider the effect of shielding of this electron due to other electrons. So we take one electron. So look at this, shielding of this 1s electron will be equals to, now look at this, we have, this is the valency shell, we have one electron left because we are taking the effect of shielding on one electron. So if you select this electron, we have another electron left because we have two electron. So ek electron aapne choose kiya, to dusra electron isko consider karenge. So now this is number of electron is 1 into electrons in the valency shell have a contribution of 0.35, so 0.35. So this is the value of sigma, 0.35. If this is the value of sigma, then the effective nuclear charge is equals to, now Z is 2, atomic number is 2, so 2 minus sigma, sigma is 0.35, so we say this is 1.65. So now look at this, theoretically this electron should have been affected by two charges present in the nucleus, but this is being in reality affected by 1.65 charge. So means the electron, one electron of this S is being shielded by the another electron, because electrons are having same charge, so because of this there is some repulsive force. Now let's take the case of lithium atomic number 3. Now we have this electronic configuration 1s2, 2s1. Now let's find out the shielding constant of this 2s electron. So now let's find out of 2s electron. Now we consider this electron. So after this electron, there is no electron left in the valency shell. So we have 0 electron into 0.35 because we are considering the effect of shielding on this 2s electron. Once we select this electron, there is no electron left in the valency shell. So number of electrons in the valency shell is 0 plus, now look at this, number of electrons in n minus, if this is n, n is 2, so n minus 1 is 1, so the contribution of electrons in n minus 1 is 0.85, so we have 2 electrons into 0.85, so this comes out to be 1.70. So this is the value of sigma felt by this 2s electron. So therefore effective nuclear charge is equals to actual charge is 3 minus 1.7, that is equals to 1.3. So now look at this, in reality this electron in 2s orbital should have been affected by 3 positive charge present in the nucleus, but this is affecting by merely 1.3 charge. Because of this electron present in 1s, this undergoes enormous amount of repulsion because of its attractive force is less. Similar look at this, we can take this. Let's have this sodium atomic number 11. So now look at this, 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s1. So this is the value of n, this is the value of n minus 1, this is the value of n minus 2. The highest occupied shell is 3. Now we'll find the shielding effect felt on this 3s electron. So now therefore look at this, sigma of this 3s electron. So after selecting this one electron present in 3s, there is no electron left, so contribution from this is 0 plus. Now we have n minus 1, so n minus 1 has got 8 electrons, So 8 into 0.85, so we have contribution of n minus 1 cell is 0.85. Then we have n minus 2, so n minus 2 we have 2 electrons, so 2, and the contribution from n minus 2 onward this is 1. So therefore look at this. So we have look at this, 8 into 0.85 plus 2, so we have this 8.8. The shielding constant of these electrons of key S, that is the valence shell, is 8.8. So if this is the case, then the effective nuclear charge is equal to actual charge is 11 minus sigma, sigma is 8.8. So this comes out to be 2.2. Now look at this. Nuclear charge is 11. So these electrons in the 3A should have been attracted by 11 protons. But if you look at this, due to the presence of these 10 electrons in the inner shell, these undergo experience a large amount of the repulsive force, because of which the actual attractive force felt by these 3S electron is only 2.2. Let's have some more examples. Look at this. Yahan pe hum log dekhte hain. Sodium, let's see the potassium, atomic number 19. We have this 1H2, 2H2, 2P6, 3H2, 3P6. So then 18. Then we have 4S1. So let's calculate the shielding effect of this 4S1. So sigma of 4S. So this is n, this is n minus 1, this is n minus 2, this is n minus 3. So electrons in n, after selection of this electron, there is no electron left, so contribution from this fourth shell will be 0. Now n minus 1, we have 8 electrons, so 8 into 0.85 plus n minus 2, n minus 3, contribution is 1, so we have how many electrons? N minus 2, 8, n minus 3, 2, so 8 plus 2, 10, so we have 10 electrons into 1. So if you look at this, this is 0, this is 6.8 plus 10, so we have 16.8. So therefore, effective nuclear charge is equal to actual charge, that is 19 minus 16.8. So again look at this, so look at this, these electrons in 4s should have been attracted by 19 protons present in the nucleus, but in reality actual this is being attracted by only 2.2 charges present in the nucleus. So this is what we call as the shielding effect, means the shielding of the outer shell electrons due to the repulsive force of the inner core electrons, and this all depends on the penetration effect of the subshells, that is the closeness of the subshell. So S being closest to the nucleus, we see the shielding effect or the value of sigma of S orbital, S electrons present in S will be greater than P, greater than D, greater than D. So D and F ball has got very poor shielding effect. So let's take the case of some D. Let me give you an example of D. Let's take this scandium, atomic number 21. So we have this electronic configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6. Then we have 3d1, 4s2. So this is, I'm just showing in terms of shell. So we are having this 4s2. So energy of 4s2 is less than energy of 3d, but in terms of shell, 3 comes before 4, so I have written 3d So now look at this. 4s, sigma of 4s. So now we have two electrons in 4s. So now look at this 4s. After selection of one, we are left with one electron. By एक तो आपने choose किया, उसको ऊपर defect करना है, तो एक electron बचा हुआ. So this is an s. So contribution is 0.35 plus. Now look at it. This is n. So this is n minus one. So n minus one d. So n minus one d has a contribution of one. So we have one into one. That is for d. Then we have look at this n minus one s. We have s and p. So number of electron is 8. So 8 into 0.85 plus. This is n minus 1, so this is n minus 2, n minus 3. So total number of electrons n minus 2, n minus 3 is 10. So we have 10 into 1. So look at this. This is 0.35 plus 1 plus 6.8 plus 10. So now look at this. This have 7. 10, 16, 17, 17.8 plus 0.35. So, let's look at this 5, 1, 8. So, shielding effect of this 4s electron is 18.85. So, therefore, the effective nuclear charge is 21 minus shielding constant 18.15. So, this comes out to be 85. This is 9, so we have 2.85. so this is what we call the calculation of the Slater's constant, that is sigma, or the shielding or screening constant. So this is the concept of the shielding effect of electrons or the effective nuclear charge, and how to calculate the effective nuclear charge, and how to calculate what is the contribution of electrons towards the shielding in terms of various orbitals.